Hello students, this class is for class 9 and today we are going to discuss about mole concept. So mole is a term that is related to the weight of reactants and products that are taking part in a reaction. So this mole ratio method is very simple and convenient method to understand that is the ratio of weights of reactants and products in a particular reaction. So what can we write about the mole concept here? That is, it is very simple and convenient method to understand the weight of reactants and product. So this mole ratio method is very simple and convenient method. Simple and convenient method to understand the weight of reactants and products. So that's why we will study today the mole concept. To make it easier and simpler, we will study mole concept. So the next is, what does this term mole represent? So this term mole represent two things. That is, number of particles present per gram atom. That is, it mole represents the number of atoms and the weight of atom or molecule. The number of atom or molecule, the number of particles that are present in a substance and the weight of the substance. That is, the weight of atom or molecule and number of atoms or molecules. That two things are related to the term mole. So we can write, so mole represents number of particles present in per gram atom or per gram molecule. This per gram atom, that is this gram atom and gram molecule term, what does that mean? We'll discuss it later. Okay, so first is number of particles and the second is weight of the substance. These two things we can get an idea from the term mole, that is the number of mole. So the weight of the substance. This. So by considering this all statement, how can we give the definition of mole? So by scientist, a particular definition of mole was given. That is, the definition of mole was given as the number of atoms present in 0.012 kg of carbon. Okay, so mole is that amount where the number of atoms or molecules or ions are equal to that what is present in 0.012 kg of carbon. So the number of atoms that are present in 0.012 kg of carbon is equal to 1 mole actually. Okay, so that is the definition of mole given by scientists. So the definition of mole we can write, definition. So mole is the amount of a substance in which number of atoms, molecules or ions this number are equal to the number of atoms present in 0.012 kg of carbon residual are equal to the number of atoms present in 0.012 kg of C12. C12 means carbon and the amount is 0.012 kg. While writing the definition, according to the scientists, you have to remember these two terms, that is, it is represented with respect to carbon, C12, and the amount is 0.012 kg. So the next is, what is the usefulness of mole? How can we use this mole, mole concept? So you know that mole represents the particles, that is atoms, molecules or ions, and it also represents the weight of the substance. So when we are representing a huge amount of substance, when we are trying to represent a huge amount of substance or reactants or products, we are using this mole term. Mole is the smaller term that represents the weight of a substance or number of particles that are present in a substance. So to represent the huge amount of term, we have to use this mole to make it simpler. Okay, so that is the usefulness of mole. So we can write usefulness of mole. So it provides a simple way of reporting a large number of molecules So, as a conclusion, we can write that it is the counting unit that is used in the chemistry. Okay, mole is actually the counting unit. So, we can also write that it is used as the counting unit . So these are some introduction part about mole, that is, what is mole and what is its definition and why we are using this mole term, why we are learning the mole concept. So the scientist William Oswald introduced the term mole in 1896. William Oswald, the scientist Oswald used this term mole, used this term mole in 1896, and the usefulness of mole is that for large amount of molecules or substances, to make it simpler or easier, we are using mole, as this is small. Okay, mole number is small, so this have a usefulness for large number of molecules. So in the next class we will discuss, that is, how mole concept, number of moles, is related to Avogadro's hypothesis or Avogadro's number. Okay.